So I've got my transcript here. I've also got some chicken nuggets just to get myself into the student mood. Here's my entire data science masters compressed into a single YouTube video. Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. My name's Leon. So I've seen a lot of people make videos on YouTube about computer science degrees, but I haven't really seen that many videos on YouTube about data science master's degrees. So I thought, why don't I just share my own data science master's experience, as I think some of you might find it useful. Back in 2018 to 2019, I was studying for a data science master's at the University of Leeds in the UK. And back then, data science master's was still a relatively new thing. And since then, the interest and demand for data science master's has only increased. So many universities are now offering data science courses or some variation of data science. So to help you get a better understanding of what it's actually like, I'm going to break it down into these key sections. Let's get right into it. So the first thing I'm going to talk about, which I think is probably the most important, is cost. Back in 2018, I paid £10,000 straight out of my pocket to do the masters. Just to demonstrate inflation in action, as of this video, the same course now costs £11,250. If you're an international student, it's going to now cost you £25,500. That's a lot of money for a piece of paper, for something that fits into this. Actually, you know what? I rarely get a chance to do this, so just give me a moment. So you see this thing right here, this costed me almost £10,000. And if you're an international student, it's going to cost you more than £25,000. Now, I say almost £10,000 because I actually got a 10% alumni bursary. So basically, I got a 10% discount. At the time, I basically paid £9,000, whereas most of the other students had to pay £10,000, unless, of course, you were an international student. So as you can see, pretty expensive overall. If you actually want to know whether or not a data science master's is worth it, I've made a video on that already, which I'll link in the cards above that you can check out as well. All right, these are good. Now that we have cost out of the way, let's talk about the entry requirements of the course. To actually apply for this particular master's that I did, you needed a bachelor's degree in a numerical or computational subject with at least a 2-1 classification. Since I have a master's degree with a 2-1 already, I passed that requirement. However, I'm not actually sure how strict this is, because I'm pretty sure I saw other students that didn't really come from a numerical or computational background. Also, if you're an international student, just like any other university course in the UK, there's an English language requirement of IELTS 6.5 overall. So just to give you an overview of how everything is structured within the course, it's basically broken down into three parts. You've got semester one, which lasts from September to December, and then you've got semester two, which goes from January to May. And then after that, of course, you've got the dissertation period, which starts right after your June exams, and that lasts all the way up until the end of August. As for the exams, you usually have them in January and June, and the examination period only lasts for around 2 weeks. Prior to the exams, you'll also have a break as well where you can actually revise for your exams. So now I'm going to go over the modules that I did during my time at Leeds. If you don't count my dissertation as a module, then I did a total of 9 modules. 7 of them were master's level modules and 2 of them were undergraduate level modules. The difference between a master's and an undergraduate level module is that there's more work to do in the master's one. So in the exams, you'll also have additional questions to reflect that. At Leeds, the undergrad modules were called level 3 and the master's modules were called level 5M. And the reason I'm telling you that is because I'm going to show you my transcript later. So just to avoid any confusion, I did 5 modules in my first semester and I did 4 modules in my second semester. Personally, I tried to have more modules in the first semester because I felt like it was harder to stay motivated after doing the January exams. So I basically tried to do more in my first semester, and then I did less in my second semester because, yeah, I knew I was going to get fed up after the exams. I felt like that was probably the smart thing to do. Each module as well is worth a certain amount of credits, with 1 credit being worth 10 hours of work. So basically, the higher the credits for the module, the more work you're expected to put in. So let's start with the first semester. The first module that I did was called machine learning, and of all the modules that I did, this was by far the most popular one. I mean, people literally had to sit on the floor on the first class because the lecturer didn't expect that many people to enroll. This was an undergraduate level module and it was my second highest grade that I got. Given the hype of machine learning these days, I pretty much had to take this module. I also took it because I'd never learned machine learning formally up to that point. In the module, we learn about things like neural networks, deep learning, reinforcement learning, and a bunch of other algorithms as well. It was pretty maths heavy for some parts of the module, but luckily I come from a maths background, so it wasn't too bad for me. It was a really good foundational module for machine learning, and in fact, some of the topics that I learned back then, I still have to talk about in interviews. So overall, a very useful module. The next one is called data management. In this one, I learn about SQL code, database normalization, database modeling. I've actually had a lot of experience with SQL before in my previous job as an analyst, so a lot of it wasn't that interesting to me. The professor was also a nice guy, but yeah, just overall, it wasn't anything special. Moving on, I did a module called distributed systems, and this one was pretty tough for me. We got to learn about things like client-server systems and fault tolerance in big systems, and also web services. We also learned about cloud computing infrastructure and how they work together with big data. Overall, I didn't do too great on this module, but I think it was a great introduction for somebody who doesn't come from a comp sci background. Next, I did a pure maths module called multivariate and cluster analysis, and I remember this one being absolutely brutal because I passed it barely by just 2 marks. I think it was particularly bad because I just didn't study maths at that level for so long. We learned about multivariate analysis, cluster analysis, discriminant analysis, simultaneous confidence intervals, and so on. And to be honest, most of that stuff I've forgotten about already. And yeah, a lot of it was very pure maths, so a lot of theory, but not much application. I was pretty satisfied with this one, even with just a pass for this module, because I absolutely hated it. Overall, good to know, but realistically, not very practical. But I think that's the case with a lot of pure maths topics anyway. Lastly, I did a compulsory module called data science. Funnily enough, this one was one of my worst grades, and but hey, I'm still working as a data scientist, so who got the last laugh? We learn about what data scientists do and data governance, you know, how to solve problems and communicate findings effectively, and also how to scale up to working with big data. And we use things like R and Tableau as well for the coursework, so that was pretty nice. Overall, I think the module was okay, and it was nice to have like a general overview of what data scientists do. Now we move on to semester 2, so right after I finish my January exams. So the first module that I did in my second semester is called statistical learning, and this was also a maths module. Basically, this was a statistical version of the machine learning module that I did. We learned from first principles about linear regression, logistic regression, decision trees, ensemble models, and also model optimization. We also learned how to statistically evaluate how to choose the best models. If you've done statistics before, you kind of understand where it's coming from. It doesn't really approach things in just, you know, an algorithmic sense. Overall, I think it was a great module, and it complemented the machine learning module that I did in my first semester quite well. Moving on, I did a module called Big Data Systems. I did pretty well in this one, and we learned about things like parallel databases, SQL, and also NoSQL databases. We also looked at how to design and implement big data architectures, and also how Hadoop and MapReduce work on big data. Overall, it gave me a solid foundation on how big data systems work. Next, I did a module called Data Mining and Text Analytics. This was actually my second highest grade, so I did pretty well in this one. It focused on applying machine learning algorithms on text data, and also how to model natural language. Personally, I've always been interested in working with text data, so this was a pretty nice module to do. And the last one that I did was called Learning Skills Through Case Studies. I got a pretty decent grade in this one, and the whole point of this module was basically to prepare us for the dissertation that we'll be doing in the summer. We did a mini project with a presentation, and then we had to do a group project with a group poster presentation. The best part was also there were no exams, so as long as you did your work and you tried your best with the team, then you were pretty much guaranteed a decent grade. And finally, we move on to the dissertation, which was an NLP machine learning project using Twitter data that I had to gather myself. I did pretty well in this with a grade of 85 out of 100, and I started working on it right after my exams in the summer. There's a lot of Python coding and math theory involved in my dissertation, and I also had to do a presentation just to go through everything that I did. And yeah, after that, I was just waiting to graduate. Another thing that I wanted to mention quickly is about the Leeds Data Science Society. So, you know, if you join a university in the UK, I'm pretty sure you'll find some kind of data science society nowadays. I ended up joining a team for a national university challenge, and it was really, really nice to have on my CV. It was a couple of months work and we didn't win, but I think overall the experience was definitely worth it. So in the end, I graduated with a distinction and an average grade of 77. It was a lot of work and a lot of stress, but looking back, I definitely don't regret doing it. It gave me a pretty good solid foundation for data science. And if you're interested in seeing all the details of my data science master's experience, I've actually written more about it on my blog, which you can check out in the link in the description box down below. I also have another video on whether or not you actually need a data science master's, which you can check out somewhere up here. If you want to see more content like this, please like and subscribe. You can also follow me on Instagram. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.